مرشدا. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم وبارك. إن شاء الله تعالى I know some people are still in the mood of Eid mood. Some people are still fasting. Some people still, you know what, relaxing, as I said today in the khutbah. So inshallah ta'ala, but this does not stop us from resuming and continuing our series that we have, inshallah ta'ala. Every Friday we have the siyam, and every Saturday we have the fiqh, inshallah ta'ala. Today, maybe like 15-20 minutes, just to get us back to what we are talking about, and to keep the brothers like connected, inshallah ta'ala. And hopefully next week everybody is done with the 6 days. I didn't start yet. Who finished the 6 days? Who finished? You started, but you didn't finish?
Who started?
Who started? No, many people started. Nobody finished the 6 days? Well, no, that's, alhamdulillah, I'm okay then. Is a kind of sheikh, my bad. Alhamdulillah, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sheikh Ahmed, in any of the ma'ana, I know he started already, mashallah. He's eating his banana. Inshallah ta'ala, as we said at the beginning, and let me remind you, the seerah class is not that we are narrating the stories of the Prophet only. The seerah, or we are covering the seerah of the Prophet, nobody can cover it, and I'm not going to be able to cover it over here only. Just highlights and selections from the seerah of the Prophet get you aware and get you, inshallah ta'ala, like eager to go and read. That's a big goal. Maybe I said something that you never heard before. It gets you, you know what, excited. You know, I want to go and read more about it. And hatta even you know it, when you read more about it, you will, you know, feel connected to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, that's the main thing about the seerah, that you take him sallallahu alaihi wasallam as an example. And I said that, and we covered that. As a father, a brother, a teacher, a husband, a leader, a Muslim brother, that was the Prophet ﷺ, and that's how we should deal with one another. The one of the main statements that I usually use when I talk about seerah is the same Sayyidina Abdullahi, Sayyidina Sa'd ibn Waqqas radiallahu anhu. Look how they, yani we were yesterday in a very nice event, me and brother Tamil, and I think Ar-Rahman was there, like celebrating some people who memorize the Quran. Like that's everybody wants that for himself and for his kids. And mashallah, Sufyan's son, they give him a nice award for memorizing parts of the Quran, and even Tamil's kids, mashallah. Something good that we are working all to memorize Quran ourselves and to teach Quran to our kids and to provide them with that knowledge. But look at what Sayyidina Sa'd ibn Waqqas said. يقول رضي الله عنه كنا we used to, the companions of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, كنا نعلم أبناءنا مغازي رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم كما نعلمهم السورة من القرآن. We used to teach our kids the battles, the seerah, the biography, the life of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم exactly as we used to teach in the surah from the Quran. The same care that you give to the Quran, you should give to the seerah. You should give to the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. طبعاً, some people, they don't give any time to anything. خلاص, خلاص, right at school, he's at school, he's doing good at school, خلاص, they don't. No, you have to do that. You have to sit with your family, talk about, يعني, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you know, get from the life of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam lessons for yourself and for your family. I mentioned today on the member that alhamdulillah we covered a very important part of the life of the Prophet ﷺ that not too many people get are interested in, which is way before the message, before he was born sallallahu alaihi wasallam, after he was born, his life before the message as a human being, as a normal person, he didn't know that he is a prophet. And that's why when you focus, when you highlight on that part of the life of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you get to know him more. You get to know more about him sallallahu alaihi wasallam as a human being. No, but no, he didn't know anything. No, yeah, we that he's going to be a prophet, but he didn't know that. He didn't, even when, as we will explain today, the last thing that we talked about was about the revelation. Last thing, last time, the last session, it was when, about when Jibreel alayhi salam came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, when he used to seclude himself, where? The sahsah baqi, every telephone I say, turn off your phone I say. وانت عارف انت عارف بتعمل ايه؟ بتسجل لي ولا ايه؟ سنتك بيضاء. What are you doing in the back? Studying? Study at home. Oh, at home بتسجل لي. So where did the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم used to go before the Masjid? غار حراء رايم؟ هو ده بقى غار الثوب. Okay, طيب. Why? Why do you think that he used to do that? نفيس.
Think.
That's good. What else? Yeah, great. So don't forget that. So don't forget that you're talking about a man of clean and clear and pure nature. And we give an example to, with another man in Ramadan who was like the Prophet, another one we have today. There was not many people, by the way, they didn't like it. They don't like that kind of worship and religion that the people of Quraysh have. How come we worship those idols? Like the Prophet ﷺ used to, like, absolutely didn't used to believe in that. So he used to seclude himself from the people, and we said that just seclusion, when you feel that you're too much, like, overwhelmed with the worldly life, and things and material life, you know what? Stay away from the people. Very good solution for you to stay away and to think and to ponder upon your situation. The Prophet ﷺ used to do that. So now, and I'm going to connect this last time to today's session, inshallah ta'ala, the Prophet ﷺ got the message. Jibreel alayhi salam came to the Prophet ﷺ two times. These are the main two main revelations, two main wahy that came to the Prophet. The first one was when he came to him in Ghar Hira and he told him, Iqra. Then he went back. So Jibreel came to him and asked him to read. I don't know how to read. Then he gave him the first few ayat from Surah Al-Alaq. Then he went back to Khadija radiallahu anha, and they went to Waraq ibn Nawfal, who told him that this exactly the same namus, the same revelation used to come to, and the same angel used to come to Musa alayhi salam, and then he hoped and he wished that he will be a young man when the people of Mecca kicked the Prophet out of Mecca. That's exactly what Waraqa ibn Nawfal told the Prophet. Then the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to Waraqa, أَوَمُخْرِجِيَّهُمْ يعني are you saying that my people will kick me out because of this? Because I'm bringing a new religion? He said that يعني no prophet came with this, the same message that you're coming with unless or until his people kick him out. They will do it. Okay? So now the wahi stops. Imagine that you are in the same situation. Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Abbas said it didn't stop for a long time, for a few days, by the way. Some people they said 40 days, but the preponderant opinion and the preferable opinion that it was not for 40 days, it was not for a few days. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam keep thinking, imagine that you are in the same situation, like somebody came to you with good news and he told you, I'm gonna come again. You're expecting the good news. You're like looking forward, something good will happen to you. So the Prophet ﷺ start like thinking and keep like waiting for Jibreel alayhi salam to come to him with the revelation. So the first revelation, Iqra, which gives the impression that you are a prophet. But as a messenger, it didn't come yet. Nothing about delivering a message to the people. That's why when you read the two ayat, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala يقول يا أيها المزمل قم الليلة. No, when all of them was a guy. is that over there? So the Prophet ﷺ, the first time Jibreel alayhi salam came to him, yeah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then he went, Zambiluni, cover me. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Ya ayyuha al-muzzammil, qum al-layla illa qalila. Still, you are a prophet. No order yet to go out and to deliver that message that you got from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as Sayyidina Jabir ibn Abdullah reported, now the Prophet is looking at the sky, and you know, he's waiting for Jibreel alayhi salam to come. So listen to what Sayyidina Jabir ibn Abdullah radiallahu anhu narrated from the Prophet. He said, قال صلى الله عليه وسلم بينما أنا أمشي إذ سمعت صوتا من السماء فرفعت بصري فإذا الملك الذي جاءني بحراء جالس على كرسي بين السماء والأرض فرعدت منه فرجعت فقلت زملوني فأنزل الله تعالى يا أيها المدثر. Now we're talking about a messenger. Who remember, I think we will talk about this before. What's the main difference between a prophet and a messenger? Ameen.
I don't remember it discussed here, but I think a prophet comes to people without who are not opposed to him, and the messenger comes with a message that is contradictory to what the people believe in and they oppose him.
عشان بحب بس ان شاء
الله النبي وحي له ولم يؤمر بالتغيير.
ايوه so if you look at the first ayah, a prophet got a message, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tell him you are a prophet, and most of the time is not asked to go and to deliver that message to the people. A messenger is a prophet who got a message and he's ordered to go out and to deliver the message. That's why they said that every messenger is a prophet and not every prophet is a messenger. And sometimes some of the messengers, they get books, some of them they get, yani, the are mentioned clearly in the Quran, 25 of them are mentioned in the Quran. How many prophets and how many messengers? Mentioned in the Fatih Hadith. I should have what was that?
Messengers,
our Rasul, 350. Yeah, 350. شيل الخمسة حط شيل الواحد حط صفر. You're very close to it. It came in the authentic hadith that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent 124,000 prophets. 124,000 prophets. And 315 messengers. Out of them, there are 25 messengers mentioned with their names in the Quran. So now we're talking about the Prophet ﷺ as a messenger now. Sayyidina Nabi ﷺ, he told Sayyidina Jabir ibn Abdullah, as he reported from him, that one day I was looking at the sky and I saw the angel who came to me before in the Hira cave, the same angel, and he is sitting on a chair between the heaven and the earth. That's Jibreel alayhi salam. So I looked at him and I got scared. Right away. So once the Prophet ﷺ saw Jibreel alayhi salam, he went home. Zammiluni, zammiluni. The same thing. Cover me, cover me. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala right away revealed to the Prophet ﷺ the beginning of Surah Al-Muddathir. Now look at Al-Muzzammil. Ya ayyuha al-Muzzammil, qum al-layla illa qalila. So in Surah Al-Muzzammil, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling the Prophet ﷺ, you have to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now you are a prophet. But now, Ya ayyuha al-Muddathir, qum fa'anzir. Now is the call for, here is the second stage of the prophethood of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The first one is preparing him. Preparing the personality to be strong enough to get the message. Now, you have to go out and you have to deliver that message to the people. Ya ayyuha al-Muddathir, qum fa'anzir. Qum fa'anzir means that arise and convey and warn warn the people against, as we will know inshallah ta'ala. Okay? Okay, so the Prophet ﷺ got the message and state, but here I need to mention something quickly before we highlight the first stage of calling people to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is in private. Because the Prophet ﷺ, when he got the message, he didn't do as the Turkish people tried to do today. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved Turkey and saved Erdogan from this big plot. He didn't think, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, of creating problems for the people of Mecca, or take over Mecca, or economically we should do this, or politically we should do this, or we should hire them, or create problems here or there. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came with the same, the main thing that I always stress. If you know a new Muslim or somebody interested in Islam, don't talk much about prayer or about zakat or about getting married to a polygamy in Islam or a hur al-ayn. Yani imagine that you're talking to a new Muslim about a hur al-ayn in general. Yeah, he doesn't have the sin, or he doesn't have the core of the religion. ولذلك, Allah sent all the prophets with the same message, which is La ilaha illallah. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam started doing this, and we will highlight this inshallah ta'ala. But before that, when we talk about wahi and revelation, because I didn't cover it last time, you're not talking only about Jibreel alayhi salam coming to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and sitting next to him and giving him or passing the revelation. الوحي كما يقول ابن القيم رحمه الله له مراتب. مين يعرف مراتب؟ يعني give me one of مراتب الوحي.
صليل الجرس.
يا صليل الجرس. انت جايب مصعب واحد. ان شاء الله عليك. طيب what else؟
الرؤية. أحسن رؤية.
الرؤية الصادقة.
صح. شباب محترم.
what else؟
إلهام.
شاهد الله.
إلهام.
يعني إلهام it can be one of them. Like it's أن ينفث الروح القدس في روعه. في روعه صلى الله عليه وسلم. Which is good. What else? يعني كان يأتي. طب بالضبط كده. طيب هناخدهم واحدة واحدة. يقول ابن القيم رحمه الله أن الوحي له مراتب. أولها الرؤية الصادقة. What happened with سيدنا إبراهيم عليه السلام? When Allah سبحانه وتعالى told him to slaughter إسماعيل عليه السلام. Right? What happened? How did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reveal to Ibrahim to slaughter Ismail alayhi salam? Inni ara ya bunayya inni ara fi manami anni al-bahr. It's walidalika qulun ru'ya al-anbiya haqq. So the first time of revelation that comes to the Prophet is the night vision, which is with the prophets is true. Whatever they see in their dreams, in their night vision is true. It's going to happen. Not you. Remember the hadith that I mentioned before? This man came to the Prophet and he told him, Ya Rasulullah, inni ra'aytu fi manami anna ra'si qad quti'at thumma dhahabtu fi athriha. So a man came to the Prophet and said, Ya Rasulullah, I saw my dream that I was beheaded. Then I followed my head, I can't see it. So then the Prophet to teach us, he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, لا يحدثن أحدكم بتلعب الشيطان به في منام. So do not just narrate everything you see in your dream. Shaitan comes and plays with your mind. And he said in a different hadith for those people, some of the Sufi sects, and I know some of them, we have them back home, he keep like, you see them on the al-ahwa. Yeah, you see them in the streets, they don't pray, they don't, like, they're not that good people, يعني. And they come to you, and all of a sudden, you know, yesterday the Prophet ﷺ came to me in the dream. Ya akhi, ma al-Nabi ﷺ ikhtarak inta. Yani, what did he do for him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to get close to him? And to see him in the dream. That's why, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, man ru'ani fi manam, faqad ru'ani haqqa. فإن الشيطان لا يتمثل بصورته. Whoever sees me in the dream, he actually sees my picture. Because shaitan cannot take the image of the Prophet, but can take the image of your dad, of your mom, of your wife for sure. Shaitan will take everybody's image except the Prophet. So number one is a ruya salat. Prophet sees something in his dream, it's real. Number two, as Brother Amin mentioned earlier, أن ينفث الروح القدس في روعه أو في روعه صلى الله عليه وسلم. That he gets something like الإلهام بالإنجليزي يعني
inspiration.
Yeah, inspiration. Like it's a divine inspiration that he gets without any touch. He didn't see a dream, like he is awake صلى الله عليه وسلم. And he gets that. And there is a nice hadith about this. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول إن الروح القدس نفث في روعي أنه لن تموت نفس حتى تستكمل أو تستوفي أجلها. خليني إيه؟ تستكمل رزقها. فاتقوا الله وأجملوا في الطلب ولا يحملنكم استبطاء الرزق على أن تطلبوه بمعصية فإنما عند الله لا يغالب إلا بطاعته. So the Prophet ﷺ, when he was with the Sahaba, and he said, you know what, Ruh al-Qudus, Jibreel alayhi salam, inspired me with this. He gave me this as a revelation. So Allah ﷺ, he said that nobody will die or dies until you, he or she get their full risk for this life. You're good, and the risk is not only the money. Meaning that you get your life as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decrees for you, you get your provision, you get everything as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decrees for you. فاتقوا الله وأجملوا في الطلب. يعني when you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, do not just be pushy and do not be almost like wants everything at a time. فإنما عند الله لا ينالوا إلا بطاعته. يعني don't just do something haram to get your risk now. يعني I have lots of examples about this, but let's يعني go to the third one or the third type of revelation. أن يأتي جبريل عليه السلام للنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم في صورة رجل. Everybody knows the hadith of Iman, of Islam, Iman and Ihsan, right? When the Prophet ﷺ, when Jibreel alayhi salam came to the Prophet ﷺ and he put his knees towards the knees of the Prophet ﷺ, right? You know that? And he put his hand on the fakhd of Nabi ﷺ and he started asking the Prophet ﷺ about what's Islam, what's Iman, and what is the Ihsan. And then after he left, Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam يقول, and in this case, by the way, when Jibreel Alayhi Salam used to come down in the form of a man, even the Sahaba used to see him as he is. And that's why Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam يقول لسيدنا عمر رضي الله عنه, أتدري من السائل? Do you know who was asking me? He said, no, عمر رضي الله عنه عليه السلام. عمر رضي الله عنه, he said that I don't know him. Then the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, إنه جبريل أتاكم يعلمكم دينكم. That was جبريل عليه السلام who came to teach you your religion through question and answer. By the way, one of the greatest ways ever of getting the knowledge in general and the Shari'i knowledge specifically is the question. How many of the hadith that you personally heard from me on the member over here that a man came to the Prophet ﷺ and asked him? The Prophet ﷺ was asked. The Prophet ﷺ, remember last week we had this hadith when the Prophet ﷺ was asked about أَيُّ النَّاسِ أَفْضَلْ, something like that. أو أَيُّ الْعَمَلِ أَفْضَلْ, right? So when the Nabi ﷺ said أَيُّ الْعَمَلِ أَفْضَلْ, قَالَ أَدْوَمُهُ وَإِنْ قَلْ. So many of the hadith, many, imagine that many of the basics of that religion, of this religion, the religion of Islam came through this. فَدُو not be little and do not be shy, because the Prophet ﷺ, يعني, they said that knowledge gonna be lost or is lost between two things, the shyness and the arrogance. يعني who is this person to ask him, for example? يعني I know more than him. How come I go and ask him in front of the people? Like I wanna know this. So I'm not gonna get the knowledge there. And on the other side, you know what? It's very bad. How come I ask in front of the people? Doesn't I don't feel like comfortable asking in front of the people. Between the shyness and the arrogance, you lose your knowledge. You don't get the knowledge. So number three is that Jibreel alayhi salam comes to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and they talk one to one. Number four is when he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and this is what Abu Rahman said, that was the hardest type of revelation. كَانَ يَأْتِيهِ sallallahu alayhi wa sallam Jibreel, يَأْتِي Jibreel كَصَلْصَلَةِ الْجَرَسِ. Can you explain it to Abu Rahman? يعني صلصلة الجرس؟ So كان يتلبس, that Jibreel عليه السلام used to come to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم and gets in him, and the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم starts sweating, even it's in a very cold day. Hatta they said that sometimes the Prophet ﷺ is riding his camel and the camel felt it. Like it feels that there is something heavy on the Prophet ﷺ and on the camel. I think one of the Sayyidina Nabi ﷺ was with Sayyidina Zayd ibn Thabit. فتقلت عليه حتى كاد فرق يعني النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم put his hand on the leg of سيدنا زيد بن ثابت and he couldn't even get it, like it was almost very يعني very tough on سيدنا زيد بن ثابت because جبريل عليه السلام was like getting into the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم to give him some revelation. طيب another situation, and this is exactly what happened in ليلة الإسراء والمعراج, that the Prophet ﷺ sees Jibreel as he is. Well, the Prophet ﷺ gave us description of Jibreel in Laylat al-Isra wal-Mi'raj, when he came and he took him ﷺ from Al-Madinah to Bayt al-Maqdis, and then from Bayt al-Maqdis ila al-Samawat al-Ula. In the journey of Al-Isra wal-Mi'raj, the Prophet ﷺ saw Jibreel alayhi salam as he is. And that's type of revelation too. Next is when he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam get the revelation straight from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When did this happen? Same in al-Mi'raj. In al-Mi'raj. And what was the revelation?
The last surah of Al-Baqarah.
Was not the prayer? Was not the prayer?
Five prayers is not an ayah. It was the last two ayahs.
Yeah, but when we say revelation, it's not only the ayat. Yeah, because when we say the Prophet ﷺ said a word, it's a revelation, right? وَمَا يَنْطُقُ عَنِ الْهَوَىٰ إِنْ هُوَ إِلَّا وَحْيُّ. Anything coming out from the Prophet, and that's a good point that you made, Amin. And we're not talking only about the ayat. When we say revelation, it's not only the ayat. It is all the revelation and the act worship that came to the Prophet ﷺ, and he passed it to us. قَلْ يَرْحَىٰ. Stay until I finish. Are you okay with that? Okay. طيب. And the last, but not, يعني the last one or the last type of.
But the last surah is of Baqarah. They also came directly from Allah.
Yeah. But we're talking about, يعني that Allah Subhanahu wa Taala gave the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم the revelation straight. And the last thing is when Allah Subhanahu wa Taala, and this is the difference between Musa عليه السلام. What's the nickname of Musa عليه السلام? Kalimullah. But he never seen Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He never get close, that close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this happened also with Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala used to talk to him. These are the times and the kinds of revelation that came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as Ibn Abd al-Qayyim had them for us. Okay, طيب. How to start the revelation? I will take just 5 minutes of your time. I promised you 15 minutes. Alhamdulillah, I'm within the 15 minutes. طيب. Should we talk about this next time?
Yes.
Yeah, I think next time, inshallah. خلاص. We'll start next time with, inshallah ta'ala, how did he, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, start? And what are some of the examples of this start? Because the Prophet, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he spent a good time calling for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala secretly. Like he was
probably
actually.
Privately,
right. Privately. Why? Because he was scared, by the way. If they knew about it, it's gonna be bad for the message itself. Like you go to a company now and you're like making some people they misrepresent Islam, actually. Like you think that you're getting like doing a great favor to Islam while you are misrepresenting Islam. So the Prophet ﷺ spent a good time, and there are some of the Sahaba, they came to him. Like there will be Sahaba after that, they want to accept Islam, and he told them just stay يعني, quiet for now, it's not the right time. What happened and what are these examples, and how did the Prophet ﷺ started the da'wah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? That will be the topic of next week, inshallah ta'ala. Jazakumullah khairan. We'll take Ahmed's point and then we'll close, inshallah.
تعال عشان اسمعك.
فلا يحملنكم
أجمل في الطلب. How do you reconcile this
repeated like يحب الإلحاح في الدعاء. طب والإلحاح is إجمال في الطلب. If you continue the hadith, you will get it. When you read the rest of the hadith, you will get it. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول فاتقوا الله وأجملوا في الطلب ولا يحملنكم استبطاء الرزق على أن تطلبوه بمعصية. يعني sometimes if I get this goal, I get it this way, which is the right way, it will take time. But there is a shortcut. The shortcut is not permissible, but we do it. يعني I can own a house. مش عارف توديني أنا بروح للمكان. I can own a house in 50 years, but I can own a house in like tomorrow. I go to the bank and sign on a mortgage deal. فاتقوا الله واجتهدوا في الطلب. ولا يحملنكم استبطاء الرزق على أن تطلبوه بمعصية. Do not just take any shortcut which is not permissible to get something that you will get if you are patient. But this doesn't mean that you don't make dua. Keep making dua. Allah Ta'ala يحب اللحوم
حق الدعاء. And then you mentioned that the Prophet started the dawah secretly, and you mentioned the example of
privately. عشان مين
بيحب privately.
يعني I don't go to my employer or to my boss tell him you know what it happened recently and it left a not good or a bad impact on the people. Like some people there was an invitation for some non-Muslims politicians to a place and a person like in front of everybody, ana ad'ukum, yeah, we have to call them for Islam. But do not forget that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says at the end of Surah An-Nahl, ادعوا إلى سبيل ربك with الحكمة والموعظة الحسنة. So that's exactly. Privately means that I use the right timing. I pass the information, a piece of information in a nice way. I don't like practice any pressure on a person just to have him accept my message, something like that, because I don't have the upper hand. And compare this to what will happen in Medina, and we will talk about it inshallah ta'ala, and you will be able to see the difference inshallah ta'ala. Okay? Jazakallah khair, and I'll see you tomorrow inshallah with the fiqh class inshallah after Salat al-Maghrib. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.